Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here to talk about YouTube and what it's like to be on YouTube. So as you know, I am a small YouTuber. I have about 1,000 subscribers, a little bit more than that, which is the greatest thing in the world. Like, I can't believe I have 1,000 subscribers. Like, honestly, when I started YouTube, that was my goal. I'm like, I want to hit 1,000 subscribers and then I will be content. And I'm so grateful for each and every one of you because you guys are so awesome. But it's hard to be a small YouTuber when you've got all these bigger YouTubers out there that are doing so much better with kind of their views and their audience and stuff, but yet you're still putting in the same amount of effort and work that they are, and sometimes you're even putting in more and you're not getting a big outcome like they are. And it can be hard. I mean, I've been on YouTube for August of 2012, I believe. No, 2013. It's been 4 years. This is my fourth year on YouTube. But I had a different channel I did with my friend for 2 years, and then I did now this one, my coming up on my 2 year anniversary in November, which I can't believe it's already been 2 years since I started this channel. Like, that's crazy. But obviously I have been moving slower. Some people have been on YouTube for like a year, and then all of a sudden they're 100,000 subscribers, and other people are around here who are like been working hard for 2 years and I've only hit 1,000. I mean, it's hard to be on YouTube and to have that. And that's kind of, I think, a hard thing that people go through when they're on YouTube. I don't know what it is, but there's just something that some people make it farther than others. And it's not even necessarily like, obviously now these days, which is kind of sad compared to the old days on YouTube, where they sat down with your iPhone in front of a window in your bedroom and just filmed and talked about a haul that you got of a bunch of stuff. And that's how old YouTube days used to be. But now if you were to do that these days, I feel like you're not going to get as many views, you're not going to get a whole lot of people interacting with you. Whereas if you are like a bigger YouTuber who you have all these lights and cameras and this massive studio and this huge collection, and that is what gets you all the views. And I think that's sad. That, like, why can't we just be sitting in front of our window in the bedroom filming on our iPhones again? Like, that, I just miss those days. And even though I even wasn't in a part of the early YouTube days, I did watch some videos. I wasn't like falling into it. I remember watching cute girls hairstyles. Like, I would look up hairstyle tutorials on YouTube and those are the ones that would come up, which I think is crazy that that's how I started it. And I remember being like, oh, this is cool. This mom makes videos of her daughter doing her daughter's hair. And I remember telling my mom that, and we just thought it was the coolest thing, but never thought that I would actually try it out. I'm just going to talk about YouTube a little bit, kind of what it's like to be a smaller YouTuber, answer some of your questions. I obviously can't give you a whole lot on, like, getting paid everything and all these sponsor things. I've never done a sponsor video. I can talk to you about, even I just had a recent interaction with a company that emailed me, that we emailed back and forth a few times, and I was going to talk about that a little bit. And yeah, so if you're interested, let's keep on watching. I'm in a hat today. It's kind of a casual day. I haven't filmed a video in like 3 weeks. Maybe it's been 2 weeks. I don't know. Any videos you've seen have been pre-filmed. So, and I just got back from the store and I got this shirt and this hat. So I was like, okay, I'll put this on. So I will do a studio tour soon. Not yet, because I'm not done with my studio yet. I'm still setting it up. I call it my studio, my beauty room, my filming room. I call it either my studio, I usually call it my filming room. But yeah, I do have my own filming room, which is really awesome. So this is just a small portion of it that you're seeing back here. This room is really small. Like, it's literally like a box. Like, here is like a little more than halfway. Like, this is like half of a wall, maybe even a little more. So, like, this is like really kind of a small room. But it's perfect for me because I don't need this massive studio. And then I have like some storage for some craft stuff because it's kind of going to be like a craft room or whatever. I actually have a bathroom, which is really weird because there's no like windows, so this can't be like an actual bedroom. It's really weird. And yeah, so I will do a studio tour once I get everything done. I still want to hang up some pictures and stuff in here. I don't have that all done, but I have pictures and stuff to be hung. I just have not done it. And yeah, so I'm still trying to figure out all this organization. I don't know what I'm doing with my hands. And yeah, okay, so that's the studio. Also, I was gonna talk about, oh, I don't even have this light on. I have a ring light in front of me. I'll just talk about it, but I'll actually show you like what I, all this stuff with my studio tour. But I'll just talk a little bit about like what's in my studio. So what I film with, I do film with a ring light and then two umbrella lights. I also have a different one that I used that was like my very first studio light that I use. It's a really harsher light, like a little more yellow, yellow tone, harsher light. So I bounce it off the ceiling sitting at a desk. And then I have, that's where I store my makeup back there. My camera, I use the Sony NEX5T. I always have it linked in the description box. I think that's, it's linked to the correct one. I don't know if they still sell the NEX5T. They might be like the NEX something, but it's very similar. They also have like the A5000 and the A6000. They are similar to this. I think this was just a little bit more smaller and compact. I like this one. This is my second camera that I've had. Is this the only one that I've had for this channel? I think this is the only one I've had for this channel. Have I? Or no? I don't remember. Is it this one? I don't know. I got this camera like either when I was in the middle of filming videos for my other channel or this one. I can't remember. But I have this camera, and then I think I'm filming on a 16 to a 50 millimeter lens, I believe. This is the lens that came with the camera. And then I also have this lens, which I really like. And this is a 55 to 210 millimeter lens. So I will film on, this one's like a really up close one. This is like a really good lens. I will film on this one when like sometimes in my old, like I had a different studio a few months ago in like a different room in my house. And when I filmed on in that room, sometimes I would set the camera up and then I would use this lens. This is a very up close lens. So if I were to put this lens on right now, it would probably bring you to like here. And so I had to sit very far back when I filmed, but I liked it because of how it kind of blurred the background a little bit more. This camera, I'm actually really surprised with. I've been saying that I want to get a DSLR camera because this is a mirror. This is called a mirrorless camera. So it's just a little bit smaller, more compact than a DSLR, like those massive ones. I do want to get a DSLR Canon one, but this one's perfect for now. Like, I really don't need it. This one works perfectly fine for me, and I feel like, yeah, it's probably not the best quality you can get, but it's also pretty good quality. And the only problem I have with Sony's is they overheat really fast, so I can only film, like, for not more than 30 minutes at a time without it dying or overheating. I really do like this lens, especially if I'm taking pictures with friends. If you ever see those posted on my Simply Hope Instagram, a lot of times I take them with this lens and I'm just farther away because this produces a lot better quality pictures. I've noticed even with this lens, even if I zoom in, it blurs out the background. Like right now, my background, it's not that blurred, but you're definitely more focused on my face now than you are in the background. You have a tripod that it's on. I have no idea what the heck this tripod is. I don't know. I can't tell you right now. I did update to a MacBook a few months ago, April? Yeah, for my birthday. So I used to edit on like a Windows PC. Loved updating to a MacBook. My MacBook is just so much faster and just so much better. I mean, my other one was a few years old, but it was totally worth it. If you're considering like upgrading to a MacBook, I would say do it, especially if you're doing YouTube, especially if you are, because it's just so much better. I edit on iMovie. I want to get Final Cut, but right now I'm just like, I don't need to spend a few $100 on an editor, and I'm perfectly fine with editing on iMovie since I don't even do that many funky edits with my iMovie as it is. If I did a few, like, it would be fun to have Final Cut to do like fun edits and stuff, but I don't do that many videos that are kind of like that, and I'm just kind of like, you know, it's not really worth it, I don't think, just to have a few extra features for like texts or whatever, which it would be fun, but I don't know, not right now. And then I do edit my thumbnails on PicMonkey. I'm pretty sure most YouTubers edit it on there. The thing I have with the problem with my MacBook is I always run out of storage. So I feel like I'm always trying to, every time I import videos, I have to delete them right off my computer after I publish them, all that, because otherwise I don't have enough storage. I have to get an external hard drive, which I've not gotten yet. Now, let's talk about more YouTube stuff. Let's talk about how much time I spend filming. So since I go to school, school has not started yet. I still have a week and a half. So when I film, I always pre-film just because of school and stuff. I don't film on every single weeknight because I have homework and stuff. And then also it's been a long day, so I look like not good for filming. So I usually film on the weekends when it's school. In the summer, I feel like I'm more efficient with YouTube in the school year than I am in the summer. Because in the summer, I usually have a lot of time to do stuff, and so then I always put it off. So like when it's the school year, I usually enjoy filming a little more because I actually have less time to do it. So then when I do get time to do it, I really enjoy it and get it done. So I pre-film a lot. I usually do like at least 3 or 4 videos at a time. So there's some YouTubers that pre-film a ton. If I'm lucky, I will get a few videos filmed and during the week if I'm just kind of feeling it and don't have, if I have time. And then, let's see here. So to film, it really depends. A lot of my videos are short. I don't do long chit-chatty videos normally like I am right now. Usually they're very fast. So honestly, I take more time getting ready to film than I do actually filming. Probably doesn't take me more than 2 hours to film. I usually film pretty fast, but it depends on how many videos I'm filming and how long they are, but it's usually around 2 hours. It's not a whole lot, 2 or 3, whatever. And so yeah, editing, it all depends on the video. Usually it takes me about an hour to edit. Let's say I import like 20 minutes of footage. It's usually not even that much. Usually it's like 15-ish. It probably takes me like an hour to finally like get it all edited, finalize things. I always get distracted doing other things on my computer. I can never just sit down and edit a video. I always get distracted. Uploading used to take so much longer until we upgraded our internet, and now it uploads so fast. It's like the world's greatest thing. Editing thumbnails, I don't usually do a whole lot of time on that. I do spend a little bit of time on it, but not, I don't spend forever. I'm like, I'll just do as good as I can in 15 minutes. And yeah, and then I do fill out the description box. I do put links. I do write out all the products and then I link them. So if you don't know what that is, a referral link. You can use different websites. There's Go Magic or like Magic Links. I don't know what the exact name is. Whatever, I have a list in the description box. There's Bitly, there's some Amazon ones, there's some Google ones you can use. You can go on those websites and you can create your own links to products. So I will like say I'm talking about this L'Oreal sponge. I will go onto Ulta's website, find the sponge, copy the URL, go onto that website and paste it, and then create a new link. And then I usually use Go Magic links for makeup products, but like if I'm linking like websites or videos or whatever, I use Bitly. And then you will put that in the description box with your product as a link. And then once people click on that link, if they purchase from that link, you get a little compensation from it. Some websites, like I'm pretty sure like Amazon, it might be paid per click. There's just a few websites that you are paid per click. And then there's some that are paid per purchase. So you get a kind of like a portion of how much they spend. So if they spend a certain amount of money, you get a portion off of that, but I'm using their link. So I mean, if you guys use my links, I'm so grateful. Obviously you don't have to use them. If you don't want to, you can always go and Google the products. I like to link them so it's easier for you, and that's also another way that I do make a little bit of money here, but it's not a whole lot. I think from, I haven't been linking my products for very long. It's probably been like almost a year and a few months. If you do use my links, thank you very much. I do appreciate that. But if you don't, you don't have to. I don't feel like you have to. They're just there to help you guys find the products. And then even just clicking them, I don't make money on that. If they're like Ulta, if they're like actual makeup products, I don't make money on that. If it's like Ulta or Sephora, only if it's like Amazon, I think I might a little bit, but it's literally only a few cents per click. And then if you purchase however much you purchase, I get a portion of that. So it's really only a couple dollars each per purchase. So it's not a lot of money. It's just a little bit. Are these websites that you can find companies to sponsor you? I'm not that big of a channel yet. There's some that require 1,000 subscribers, but then you have to have at least like 1,000 video views on each video or most videos or something within a month. And I don't get that yet. So there's that. There's some that require 3,000, 5,000, 10,000, whatever. You can sign up for that, and then companies can find you to contact you and to sponsor you for a video. But yeah, I'm not big enough for that stuff yet, but I have looked into it. And then, so making money on YouTube, if you don't know, you get paid per like advertiser. So that's why there's ads in front of our videos. They're called monetizing. So you monetize your video and then ads will play in the beginning and then you'll get paid. Once you hit 1,000 subscribers is when you can actually get paid for it. And you really only start to see that money come in as the subscriber count gets bigger. I have made a few $100 so far from hitting 1,000, which is really great. I mean, it's a good money to make on the side. It's nothing like say you're working a part-time job, or like say, since I'm in school, like after school, I work like a few days a week. Probably not gonna make as much as you would if you worked like every single day after school every week. I would definitely not make that much. But YouTube is a nice thing that this is like a kind of a side thing. It's more of a hobby for me. It's not even like I'm working. And so I don't want to say it's easy because it is a lot of work, but it's something that comes natural to me and that it's so fun to do that it's just like I get paid, which is just even more like encouraging, and it's just like exciting because then it's like I am doing something I love, but yet I'm still making money on it, and I'm not, it's not a big amount because I'm only at 1,000 subscribers, so it's not a huge amount, but it is like a good amount, like a decent amount of money for somebody my age. If you guys are ever looking into doing YouTube or something, definitely like don't go into it thinking you're gonna make money, because that's not how it works. I have put so many years into YouTube and now it's finally starting to pay off. I have, oh my gosh, you guys, I've been doing this channel for 2 years now, and now I'm finally starting to make some money on it, off of it, and it's just like so amazing and kind of like it's paying off from my hard work that I've put into it. So if you want to start a channel, don't go into the mindset that you're going to get paid or you're doing it for the money, because then it's not going to be enjoyable and you're not going to like it. I'm not making a whole lot. Like, it's not the same as a part-time job or anything, and it's not with my small numbers. It's a lot of work. So it's definitely more work than just like working at McDonald's and just like, oh, you fill out an application, you get accepted, da da da, you're there, and now you're getting paid in 2 to 3 weeks from when you applied or whatever. It's different than that, whereas I'm on YouTube, it's taken me 2 years to finally start getting this. I mean, obviously there's easier routes. If that's my purpose and I wanted to make money, that I could have done an easier route for that, but that's not the point in why I started YouTube. When I started YouTube, I was pretty young with my friend. I don't even think I knew how all that worked. Like, I didn't even think I knew that you could get paid for it. What I think about sponsor videos is another thing. I don't mind sponsored videos if people genuinely enjoy a product. So if I like say, hey, I love this highlighter so much. Well, I do love this highlighter. It's like my all-time favorite highlighter. If Pixie reached out to me and was like, hey, would you do a sponsor video on talking about our products? It wouldn't have to be very long, blah, blah, blah. This, I would definitely do it because I genuinely love this product. I don't mind if people do sponsor videos. Obviously, if they're doing sponsor video after sponsor video after sponsor video, then it's really annoying and it's like, okay, do I really trust you? And there's some YouTubers that I really love that have started to do that a little bit, and I'm like, okay, you should probably tone it back a little bit. But if it's like once a month or something, I think it's great because it's an extra way that their hard work is paying off because they're making a little bit off, of a commission off of it, and they're also putting a lot of effort into it, and they already genuinely love the product and they're already talking about the product, then it's like, why not do it? That's what I say. I mean, if this person has already talked about this product a lot before and now they're getting sponsored because a company saw that they love it so much and then they want them, they're just paying them to talk about it even more. I mean, I think it's great because this person already loves it. Now, if somebody, I've never heard this person talk about this product before, or it's a completely, like somebody is doing a makeup, like me, say, for example, I do makeup videos, and then somebody asked me to sponsor about a cleaning product or something, I don't know, then I'd be like, what? Like, you usually do makeup videos, and I could say, like, even if you love that cleaning product, it's kind of like, this is a makeup channel, and this person, somebody is not going to want to watch you talk about a cleaning product, you know what I mean? So it kind of has to go hand in hand with your channel, but I really don't have a problem with it unless somebody is constantly doing them all the time, and I feel like I can't trust them. Scent PR was another thing I wanted to talk about too. No, I do have a hard time with that. Those PR unboxings, I do like to watch. Like, Tati's are kind of fun because they're enjoyable just to see, like, people's reaction on what they're getting. I don't necessarily watch them to be informed about, like, telling you all the new products that are coming out and being informed. I don't necessarily like that. I just like the more kind of enjoyable. Like, Tati kind of makes it just fun to unbox. That's what I like, the more unboxing, not really learning what's coming out. And so I think when people get too into it, like showing you what's coming out and all that, then I don't really like it as much. And I can see how people get jealous. I mean, I don't have a problem. Like, I think they're enjoyable to watch. But then, yeah, as a small YouTuber, I can tell that, oh, I didn't get sent any of this. And obviously, it's different because I'm not getting sent any. Whereas somebody who could be getting sent some of it and not all that a different person's getting. But I'm not getting sent any. The only products I get sent are from Influencer, which is a website where you can review makeup products. And then, like, sign up for surveys, and then you can kind of get drawn for a Vox box or somebody to send you a product, so on and so forth. I can link Influencer in the description box. It is free, and I do like that. And the higher impact score, which is the higher amount of subscribers or followers you have on all different social media accounts, platforms, whatever, the more of an impact scoring, the more chances you are to get something sent to you. But yeah, I do get reached out by some companies. I've had a company send me a curling iron before. There's been a company that sent me like this detox tea. This is the problem I have too. With some companies, they'll be like, hey, can I send you the product in return for a video? And I'm like, you can send me the product, but I can't guarantee that it's going to be in a video. If you want me to talk about your product so bad in a video, then it would have to be sponsored. And I really, if I don't even know your product, and I would have to test it out for a while, and I would have to know that I for sure love it before I share it with somebody. And I wanted to give you an example. I just got done emailing a company a few days ago, and it was about this mascara and lash serum. And they had just said that it was awesome, and it sounded very good. I'd like to ask for one vlog about, I'm not going to talk about the company just because I don't want to throw shade at it, but because I'm sure it's a good company. They would like to, we would like to ask for one vlog about the mascara and serum. In exchange, we could send you it for free if you post a link on your channel, leading us with the hashtag, whatever. I don't like when companies do that. I'm not going to guarantee that I'm going to talk about it. And so, I mean, I politely responded saying I would love to give it a try. However, I cannot guarantee a video featuring the product. If I have a strong opinion, then it may be mentioned, but not as an individual video. Any opinion I would have would be honest, completely honest, even if it was sent to me for free. And I said, if you still would like to send it over, please let me know. And that's the kind of thing, too, is you have to include that. When I email companies, I'm always like, I'm going to be dead honest. If I love this product or hate it, it could end up in the best product I've ever tried in my entire life, or it could end up in the product I regret having. Like product regrets. I mean, it could end either way. And companies have to know that that's what you're going to be like. I'm going to either talk good or bad. I'm not, just because you're sending it to me does not mean I'm going to talk good about it. It'd be the same as if I was buying a product and I liked it or I didn't. That doesn't mean I'm always, if I didn't like it, then that's the same thing as if I got it sent to me and I didn't like it. And so then they asked, can you at least assure that it'll be mentioned? I'm sorry, but I cannot guarantee it's going to be in a video. I don't like feeling pressured with that stuff. Yes, I probably will end up mentioning it in a video at least once or twice. Most products, because I don't have a huge collection, so I probably would end up mentioning it. But it doesn't necessarily mean I'm going to give you like information and leading you to their website and everything. If I mentioned it, I'd be like, hey, liked this mascara, check it out. Hey, liked the serum, whatever. Or hey, I hated this mascara, trash. That's the kind of thing if I were to mention it in a video. I'm not going to mention it, but then link their kind of site and everything. So that's kind of what they wanted. Because when they say that, they're not saying, hey, I want you to just talk about it. Like, I could just be like, hey, I like this mascara, go buy it, whatever. They're wanting you to be like, hey, I like this mascara, the link to the website is down here, and here's your code, and all these things. Because I can't guarantee that. And I'm not going to set myself up for that. The company was different. They didn't want a full video, which is perfectly fine. I didn't want to feel like I had to talk about this product, especially if I didn't want to. And I also don't want to tell a company I will and then not do it, because then I would lose their trust and so on and so forth. So that's just the kind of thing. And then they just said that they would decline my terms because I just said I would not do a video. And yeah, and so I think some of you are looking at me like, you're crazy, you could have gotten a free mascara. And this stuff was expensive. Like this mascara, the serum was like $50, this mascara. And that was another thing I took into consideration too. I was like, if I was going to recommend this product, if I was somebody watching this video, would I go and buy it? And I was like, you know, this is $50. I can't afford $50 for an eyelash serum. And so I was thinking, yeah, it'd be nice to get it sent to me for free. But I'm also thinking of my subscribers and how they probably would be in the same boat as if I was watching a different person's video on that. And I would have been like, I'm not paying that much money for a serum. Even if it was amazing, I wouldn't do that. This is kind of what I feel about with companies, is that some of them will kind of get you, especially the smaller companies, they'll kind of be like, hey, I like your videos. Will you, if we send this to you for free, will you mention it in a video? Catch like, oh, you have to link this in the description box. And it's kind of like, it's almost like a sponsored video. And I'm not doing that for free, even though it sounds greedy, but it's like, that you're kind of talking like a sponsor video, and I'm not. And even in sponsor videos, that's the thing with sponsor videos too, is when you mention a product, you mention it, and then you usually link that their information in the description box, and that's it. The whole video isn't usually about that product, and so it's usually just briefly mentioning like, hey, it's a sponsor, whatever, and then it's linked. that wouldn't be the case because this wouldn't be sponsored, but it's pretty much the same thing, except for I wouldn't be sponsored and I wouldn't be getting paid for it. So it's kind of, they're kind of ripping you off in a way too. So I don't know. That's my thoughts on that. If you guys have any more questions, please let me know them down in the comments. And if you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, those questions I will either try and respond to or I will answer them in a completely different video. So yeah, and if you guys really like this kind of video, please give it a thumbs up because then I know that you will enjoy this type of video. I think it's fun to kind of chit-chat and just talk about it. So yeah, and I'm sorry this is really long, but I did ramble a little bit. A studio tour I'll probably have coming in a little while once I get everything hung up in here. And yeah, I love you guys so much. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe if you would like to stick around and catch my future videos. And until then, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, you guys.